Complete Sports, Sports Day, NAN, and Top Radio.
Yeah.
We'll be playing from Group D. All right, so that's what it looks like from
an opportunity for sports journalists to show football followers and fans that
it's done.
You know, we just don't talk with our mouth. We can actually get to the field and do it, and not mainly the pot bellies and the sizes. Guys still know how to make good use of
and it's a very good opportunity to
still know how to make still know how to make good use of their legs and of their football brain, and of course an opportunity to bond, an opportunity to you know, brainstorm, get ideas, and it's always good, you know, take time off. And I love to see. I'm already imagining.
You should be part of the channel's team.
I always love to work from behind the scenes.
Behind the scenes.
Yeah.
No, you have to get us to the pitch this time. All right, but it's going to be plenty of fun, and maybe we'll try to get, if the footages are good enough, and you won't be laughing at us, we'll try to put some of those footages as well on TV for you to see. But then you can take time out to enjoy our sport writers playing the game. All right, from sport writers, now let's come down. Still talking about channels and the impact that Channels National Kids Cup is having on the kids. That's not just what the impact is. It is also having impact across Nigeria. This is an interesting story from Ilorin, Kwara State. A school in Ilorin called Focal Point School sent us this story that because of the way Channels Television have helped to develop grassroots, they got inspiration from Channels and they are also putting together an under-13 invitational tournament. They said they are inspired by what Channels is doing to develop grassroots sports from primary schools. And they are also putting together this tournament, and you can see the results on your screen. You have the school Surprise and Champion playing out, their clubs playing out a goalless draw. And then you had Focal Point beating Arsenal Kiddies 5-3. You have Surprise beating Future Stars 3-1. These are results from some of the qualifying games. They had the semi-finals where Focal Point beat Surprise 1-0. And then Arsenal Kiddies beat Champion 1-0. And today we had the final game of their competition, and it was Focal Point School beating Arsenal Kids 2-1 in the final. So we are encouraged, and they put this tournament together to also coincide with the end of the Ramadan. All right, so Channels inspiring people in far away Ilorin, Kwara State into doing something for kids. Amazing.
It's good when you hear names closely associated with Channels Kids Cup, and you hear them doing what
the
they've seen.
The impact that it is having on other people.
They've been able to tap into what they've seen, the quality of the competition, all the other things, and the main aim, which is to develop the game from the grassroots. I'm happy when I see things like this. I hope that that there's going to be a spillover effect, not just in Lawrence, Sokoto, everywhere. I will begin to see all of those things, and you know, and for all you know, the NFF is already even taking seriously as well. So all of this, there's going to be the ripple effect, and you know, Nigeria will only be the better for this.
And I think the message to Channels is that all it takes to turn things around is to start something good. Others will join in, and I think that's the message for Channels TV. Look at what is happening. They are inspired by what Channels is doing. All right, let's go now to Group Premier League. The outstanding the match day 18 gameplay today. Away win for Warri Wolves, and this is the 18th away victory of the season, and we have just played 18 round of games, so it looks like if it goes on this way, yeah, maybe we could be having 38 away victories by the end of the season. It's really amazing. And Bola Salami among the scorers for Warri Wolves in this one, his seventh goal of the season.
Well, in spite of all the issues that the Warri Wolves do have, I'm happy for them that they've been able to get this away victory. And we've said a lot of things about Warri Wolves being like a Super Eagles team B. You have a lot of players who play in Warri Wolves that are key members of the Super Eagles. And one will only feel that if that team is well managed, I mean, I don't believe Warri Wolves are where they should be in terms of the potentials that they have. I'm not surprised when I see these results. I'm hoping that quality management, that's the only way to get the best results from these guys. And I hope, you know, this we hear about all of those issues being
salaries and all of that,
you know, being sorted out, we begin to see this kind of results, and you know, see stars develop from the domestic scene.
All right, that's an interesting one. And talking about stars developing from the domestic scene, let's quickly take you to Akure and talk about Super Eagles defender. He was at the World Cup for Nigeria and has been a key member of our own base Eagles. We're talking about Kunle Odunlami. Gone to the wrong side of the law with his club Sunshine Stars, but it looks like they are mending fences. And the 2.6 million naira fine imposed on him, slammed on him for absconding, it will be revealed downwards, according to the story that we're getting from Akure, from the Ondo State Football Agency. And that's because Odunlami has apologized, is sorry for what he did, and is ready to be more professional in his attitude.
Yeah, that's the only way to go, really. I'm happy with the turn of events. You know, I wouldn't want us to damage ourselves. I'm interested. This guy plays for the Super Eagles and is a product of the domestic league. And so we will be interested in what happens to him. I'm happy the way the Ondo State Football Agency and Sunshine as a club have went about this. They've shown their displeasure with the way the player has behaved. But again, you don't throw the baby away with the bathwater. So they're trying to see how they can. And, you know, of course, there's always the little matter of getting something from this as well. And that probably that's why we're seeing a common sense solution to the problem. Because both parties will be losers if they don't really sit down. I'm happy the young man has apologized, apology accepted, and we move on from there. And you know, that's what we always say about when you leave a place, just close the door gently, because you might have to walk through that door again
on your way back in
with fences mended. Who knows? I mean, maybe after his football career, football sojourn in Europe or wherever, he could still come back, you know, and do something with Sunshine, even if coaching or whatever, or even if it is still, if he's still active and he wants to play football. So all of these issues, and I think it's a lesson for the other guys, the Azubike Igwe case of this world, those guys who feel that they deserve more, because that's what prompts players to behave in this way. Players who feel I'm a Super Eagles material, I deserve more than I'm getting, and we're maybe still planning to go AWOL. I think this will serve as a deterrent.
Okay. All right, so that's an interesting one. Let me run to Twitter very quickly and pick out a few more comments. Adefemi Ayodeji at Ayostov says he wants to know what will happen to Omashone Aluko, who will now play in the championship. What will happen to his Super Eagles career? Let's leave that for Coach Sunday Lisa to decide. He's the man in charge. He will know who to call up.
But a lot of people have decided to interpret his speech in one way or the other, and some of us feel, I mean, like you said, it would be interesting for me to see the call-ups. With what he said, if you're playing, you specifically mentioned the lower leagues, and he said even in the Premier League. So it's going to be interesting. You know, it's too early to judge.
To begin to, yes.
But what people will say is that, where are the players in the first place? If you're ruling out some. But it will be interesting in days to come to see what happened. The quality players are not there, and Olise admitted that by himself. And so we'll wait to see.
All right. I think the new man wants to just set standards. That's the context for which I see. He wants to set standards for all players, wherever you are, to aspire to. So let's wait and see what happens in the next couple of days, and we'll be able to see a lot more.
And if you're a striker, you are not fast, you don't have pace, you better find something to do about your pace.
All right, so that you can get a look in into the national team. All right, let's pause for a break now. When we return from this break, Austin Okonakwa will be joining me for a few minutes. We'll just spend time to look at the Lagos International Badminton Classics currently going on. And then don't forget that Femi Adefeso is also waiting around. He has plenty of basketball for us on the show tonight. So there's still plenty more for you. We'll begin to talk more after this timeout.